south of downtown San Diego's towering skyscrapers, where hundreds of homeless people sleep in large tent shelters or on the streets and get their meals from soup kitchens or trash cans.
Take a deep breath for me.
Dr. Harris Niazi cares for some of the region's poorest residents.
We had a patient just that came in last week who just wanted to put his feet in warm water and, you know, he had soap with him. We didn't necessarily have to charge for that visit. You know, we just give this guy a bucket, here, wash your feet. Sure, you know, we'll take care of you. We do the best we can.
Some who seek help at the modern clinic in Logan Heights are among the millions of Californians who joined the Medi-Cal rolls under Obamacare, like 74-year-old Lorenzo Sarabia.
I had a heart attack 3 years ago, and I was in the hospital for 4 days.
Now he's homeless and sleeps on city sidewalks. He relies on the clinic for ongoing care.
For me, it's very important because if we didn't have that, you know, we'd probably die on the street.
Dr. Niazi says others who come to the clinic have no insurance at all.
We serve a large amount of homeless people in this area.
Patients come in with typical issues, flu, rash, infections, but many have a multitude of complex problems.
Medical problems, psychiatric problems, and on top of that, the social, financial, and drug issue that's tremendous.
The 30-year-old assistant medical director for Family Health Centers of San Diego says his job requires a special set of skills.
It's very easy to throw a pill at somebody, very easy to diagnose, and you know, you read the book and it tells you, okay, well, this is the problem, this is the management, this is the treatment. But for patients that are non-compliant, they're poor, or they don't speak the same language as you, you have to know how to talk to these people.
How to talk to people without being judgmental, he says, and how to listen, and most important, to understand where they're coming from.
To be able to treat them, you have to know what it feels like to be in their shoes.
Dr. Niazi knows exactly what it feels like.
And I was a war refugee from Afghanistan. I came when I was about 1 year old or so, and we came to the Bronx, New York.
He grew up in poverty and watched his parents struggle with health care. It's why everyone at his clinic is treated as someone.
In the end of the day, I don't think it matters to me if you're black, white, if you're gay, if you're Muslim, if you're Latino, if you're undocumented, or if you're documented. When you're a patient in front of me, you know, and you're ill, we're going to treat you the same no matter what.
Finding dedicated doctors like Dr. Niazi to work at Family Health Center's 23 primary care clinics in San Diego, serving 3,000 people each day, is a challenge amid a growing physician shortage.
So our goal is to really connect them with community medicine.
Anthony White is director of the center's community and government relations.
Being a nonprofit organization that provides care for free sometimes, it's hard for us to pay competitive rates.
And have you had any shortness of breath more than usual?
That's why the center started a doctor residency program that trains and works to retain physicians to help fill the gap. The 3-year program gives medical graduates real-world experience with an emphasis on empathy and improving health disparities.
They're rotating throughout our clinics at Family Health Centers of San Diego, but then also they need to learn about hospital inpatient care, so they're working with Scripps Mercy Hospital.
White says research shows graduates are more likely to stay in practice where they trained. He says last year nearly 1,000 medical students applied for 6 open residency slots.
It's not always necessarily on, you know, who has the best grades or who is, you know, the most stellar person. A lot of it, especially with our clinic, is their dedication to serving the community. Do they have that in their background?
That's why Sarah Matthews applied. The 3rd-year chief resident knows a medical specialty would boost her salary, but it's not just about the money, she says. It's about helping those in need.
I also really loved refugee and immigrant health, so I was really excited to come here where we have more than 41 languages spoken in our clinic.
There are also financial tuition incentives for working in underserved communities that began under Obamacare. It's a program Governor Gavin Newsom plans to expand using Proposition 56 tobacco tax money. Dr. David Bazzo is president of the San Diego County Medical Society.
$190 million is going to go towards loan repayment for those physicians that go into a traditionally underserved area to practice.
Bazzo says the timing couldn't be better. 25% of California doctors are nearing retirement, just as aging baby boomers are requiring more health care. He says the physician shortage will hit underserved areas hardest.
Everything else is going good.
Dr. Niazi is a recent graduate of Family Health Center's residency program.
I couldn't see myself doing anything else.
It's a place he plans to stay because it's where he's needed most. Susan Murphy, KPBS News.